Hello, I am Sagar Gupta, Assistant Professor in Computer Engineering Department at Purnima College of Engineering, Jaipur. Today, I am going to discuss about a microprocessor. The microprocessor 8085 is an 8-bit general purpose microprocessor that can handle 2 to power 16 equal to 64,000 memory byte is there. It has a 40 pin and uses the plus 5 volt of the power. It can run at a maximum frequency of the 3 MHz. So, before moving ahead, I just want to discuss the basic definition of the microprocessor. So that I can say here microprocessor is a clock-driven, multitasking, programmable, register-based processor. In this definition, I have just used the four terms. Number one, the clock-driven, then multitasking, programmable, register-based processor. Clock-driven means we can see here that microprocessor required a 3 MHz frequency for the operation. Multitasking, it means it can perform the various arithmetic and logical operation like addition, subtraction, AND, OR, NOT, complement, compare, increment, decrement, rotation, etc. Then programmable, we can program in the assembly language, then microprocessor will convert into the machine language for the further processing. Register-based processor, the microprocessor have the 7 basic 8-bit registers. Names are A, B, C, D, E, H, L. Now we just move on the 40-pin IC diagram of the microprocessor. The total 40-pin IC diagram of the microprocessor can be grouped into the 6 groups. Number 1 is the address bus, then data bus, control and status signal, power supply and frequency, externally initiated signal, serial input and output. Ports are there. So we just move on the 40-pin IC. So this one is the 40-pin IC diagram of 8085 microprocessor. We can see here at the left hand side we are having the 20-pin and at the right hand side again we are having the 20-pin IC. So we just move one by one to each pin. Now pin number 1 and 2. The pin number 1 is noted by the X1 and pin number 2 noted by the X2. The pin number 1 and 2 are connected with the crystal oscillator which generates a 6 MHz frequency for the microprocessor. Pin number 3, 4 and 5. These are the pins responsible for the serial input output. Pin number 4 is the serial output data and pin number 5 is the serial input data. So that we can say pin number 4 and 5 will use with the SI or DI command. SI means set interrupt and DI means disable interrupt is there. Pin number 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. These pins are from the interrupt group. So that we can say pin number 6, the trap has the highest priority. RST 7.5, 6.5, 5.5, these are the vector interrupt. Vector interrupt means they are having the predefined memory location is there. Then INTA, that is the acknowledgement signal of the interrupt for the second one processor or we can second one and other any ICs or device. Now pin number 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19. These are the multiplex address and data bus. So that we can say here D0 to D7 are referred to our data and A0 to A7 we are referred with our lower address is there. Okay, now we can see at the pin number 32, that is a VPP or we can say ALE. ALE means address latch enable. When address latch enable equal to 1, then pin number 12 to the pin number 19 generate the address. And then VPP or we can say ALE equal to 0, then pin number 12 to the pin number 19 generate the data. So that we can say the VPP or ALE directly associate with the pin number 12 to the 19 for the and this is responsible for the generating or data which we are required at that time. Now pin number 20 is the VSS, that is the ground is there. Pin number 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. These are the A8 to the A15 or we can say this is the higher order data line. Address lines are there. Pin number 29 and 33, S0 and S1, this is the control signal. Then we can say if we just combine the S0 and S1, then we can say the possible value for the S0 and S1 are 00, 01, 10 and 11. For the 00, we can say no operation and halt is there. For the 01, we can say write operation is there. For the 10, we can say read operation is there. And for 11, we can say opcode fetches there. Okay. Now pin number 30 and 31. These are associated with the read and write operation. Then we can say they are the active low signal, because we can see here write bar and read bar here. So we can say ki when this signal goes to the low, it means pin number 30 when goes to the low, then microprocessor will perform the write operation. When 31 or write operation will goes to the low, then we can say it will perform the read operation is there. Pin number 34, I input output oblique memory bar. When this one pin equal to 0, then it will perform the operation with our memory. And when IO oblique memory bar equal to 1, then it will perform the operation with our input and output. Then pin number 35, 36, 37, 38 and 39 are different control, and we can say peripheral signals are there. Now pin number 40, that is the VCC. In the case of 8085 microprocessor, VCC equal to plus 5 volt. Now we just move on the architecture diagram of the microprocessor. Then this one is the architectural diagram of the microprocessor. We can see here we are having the all register arrangement. B, C, D, E, H, L, stack pointer, program counter is there. Here we are having the arithmetic and logical unit is there. The accumulator is a part of arithmetic and logical operation unit. We can say one temperature register is there. All the buses are here. It may be data bus, it may be control bus, it may be address bus. So all things are, we can say, include in this diagram. Now, in the definition, I told that ki microprocessor is a register-based model. So we can say we can see in this diagram actually. Ki first one is the accumulator. B, C, D, E, H, L. These seven are general purpose register which are having and can store the 8-bit data only. And this one is the flag register is there. The flag register also contains the 8-bit, and the structure of the flag register we will discuss after this one slide. If we are having the 16-bit data here, so that we can say we can club the BC, DE, HL as a pair. So that we can say BC as a pair, BC pair, it can store the 16-bit data. DE as a pair, it can store the 16-bit data. HL as a pair, it can store the 16-bit data. Now at the bottom side, we can say we are having the data bus for the 8-bit and address bus for the 16-bit. Now I just discussed the flag register here. So this one is at the bottom side, we can see the structure of the flag. So we can say this one is the D0 bit, D1 bit, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6 and D7. This one is the MSB bit, this one is the LSB bit. So that I am just starting with the MSB bit. This one is the F is referred with our sign bit. Z is referred with our 0 bit. AC is referred with the auxiliary carry. P is parity flag. CY is the carry flag. S is the sign bit. The sign flag is set if bit D7 of the accumulator is set after an arithmetic and logical operation. So that we can say S equal to 0 for the positive number and S equal to 1 for the negative number. Z equal to 0 flag. Set if the result of the arithmetic and logical operation is 0, otherwise is reset. The flag is affected by the operation on the accumulator as well as other register. Auxiliary carry. This flag is set when a carry is generated from the bit D3 and passes to D4. This flag is used only internally for the BCD operation. Parity flag. After an arithmetic and logical operation, if result has an even number of 1, the P flag is set, otherwise it is clear. So the flag can be used to indicate even parity. Now last one is the carry flag. Carry is set when result generate a carry also borrow the flag. So we can say these are the basic structure of the microprocessor, and this is one is the structure of the flag register. The remaining we will discuss in the next one slide. Thank you.